we were trying to get people here, people were saying, oh, I needed you last week, or I could have done with you yesterday, or my shower's playing up, or my toilet's playing up. And I'm happy to give plumbing advice out. But when you go to a party, I go to a party and everybody wants to tell me about their plumbing stories. And so one time I thought, I know what, I'll go to a party and I won't tell anybody I'm a plumber and see what happens. I told them I was a tax inspector.
Big mistake.
Like, I cleared the room, nobody spoke to me at all. Not only did they not speak to me, but they told their friends not to speak to me either. So,
Hattie looked inside the box and saw the baby girl. She couldn't stop the love from pouring out of her because she felt like this was a gift from God. And she vowed that it didn't matter how long this baby girl lived, that she would give her all the love that she could. So they kept the baby. Far from dying, the little girl thrived. She grew up. She had a few trials and tribulations, obviously, like we all do. She got married and came to this country. She grew up into being a remarkable woman. She had 5 children, and I'm one of them.
But at the same time, talking about converging, at the same time, I was trying to think about how I could be a better plumber. Because I have some dreams that, I'm a passionate plumber. You might not think that plumbing is that exciting, but actually, without it, we wouldn't have the civilization we have. And there are places in the world where to turn something on in the middle of nowhere and get water, this is magic. And, you know, there are many places in the world where that doesn't happen.
Thank you very much, and, you may applaud.